Alright, I can't take this anymore. It's out of my eyes. Okay, roll the intro. What's going on, guys? My name's Dominic, and for you guys today, I'm just bringing you a little bit of a specialish, different-ish video here. And just as you can see, our clan is doing absolutely amazing at the moment. If you see my war recap videos, just our warlock has been absolutely brilliant at the moment. And I just want to give you guys a few tips on how to make your clan awesome. So I joined this clan when it was on like 120 wins or something. So I've participated in about 75 wars, I think, so far. I've participated in about 65 wars in this clan. I have dropped out a few I'm upgrading heroes. But how to be successful in clan wars also here. So yeah, the war recap video for this one will come soon, because Look at this pure domination. This war's out going absolutely amazing. Except that. But, no, sorry. That was dumb. Anyway, so yeah. Showing you guys. So, the bases we use, that's going to be your first tip here. If you guys are good at 3-starring Town Hall 9s, and when you can use Go Hog or Go La Luna attack strategies, and yeah, so my first tip is, you're not really going to want to be using bases like this from their opponents. These bases with very centralized clan castles, Queen is very vulnerable, and a very symmetrical base here, these ones can get destroyed very easily. Along with grounded X-Balls, this base got destroyed by Junkyard by just a simple Go La Luna. Along with other bases, for example, I think every single base in their clan had a centralized clan castle and centralized town hall. So again, this one again, the queen and king very vulnerable at the top. Very spread out base around the sides, that's not that great. And here, giant bombs, there's only two places it could be a double giant bomb, and that's there and there and there and there. And our attacker predicted it brilliantly and wrecked it in first attack here. And another one again for Town Hall 8s. These bases, okay, Town Hall 8's fair enough. Oh, this is Town Hall 9 still. Again, look at this Town Hall 9. You're too weak to be in war. Grounded X-Blows again. You did get attacked by Gohog because Golar's quite hard for lower Town Hall 9s. But again, bases like this, you shouldn't be going Town Hall 9 when you've got a level 7 king and very weak defences, because you're just going to struggle once. And this guy got absolutely wrecked. And just having a look at his troops, like, you can't see a main war troop he has that is a good level. So you don't want, that's another tip, you don't want to be accepting players if you're running your own clan. You don't want to accept players that are fairly weak here without any good experience in based on his war troops. Again, looking at Town Hall 10 bases, ones like this Town Hall base here, it looks very simple to easily earthquake one side. It hasn't been attacked yet, so maybe in a walk recap I'll show you this number one attack, if it's two stars. But yeah, so as you can see, King and Queen hiding at the bottom. All you need to do is attack directly from the top, and you're easily getting a 2-star, because look, the King and Queen aren't even covering the top part of the Town Hall, so there you go. And the X-Bows, and the Inferno Towers. Jesus, this base is actually a lot worse than I thought. Look at that, Inferno Towers not covering. All you have to do is attack from the top. It's just the heroes he has good. So don't use war bases like this where the King and Queen and the Inferno Towers don't even protect the Town Hall. That one is definitely going down first try. And he's coming soon, I think. Oh, someone's going to attack it. So just having a look at our bases, I'm just going to scroll through them. I think for our higher Town Hall 9s, I don't think you use those anti-3-star, but these bases are still quite solid. A centralized clan castle only, and a Town Hall a bit to the side. Centralized clan castle means it's going to be quite hard to lure out the clan castle. And they did have it as well, but their ones were easily to lure out still. Again, Queen in a very good position here. She is protected by an X-Bow and giant bombs and Teslas as well. And looking at number 8 base here. Again, centralized clan castle. This one, we want this place to change his war base. We did ask him to change his war base, so hopefully he will. all of our clan aren't fan of this war base, but he forgot to change it, or he just didn't want to change it by this war. Again, this one, I think this is one of my speed builds here. Look at that, centralized clan castle, queen is centralized as well, and king is protecting the queen. That's what you want, so you can't get go hogs very easily here, nor go lard loons. Again, this one here, again, another centralized clan castle, protected by the queen, who's even more central than the clan castle, protected by the king if you attack from this side, if they try attack from the top, the town hall is there, that's going to slow them down a ton. And if they try attack from this side here, you have a Tesla. And yeah, so again, in these kind of bases, now I'm just going to start skipping through them, and you're going to see from now on there's not going to be those very symmetrical bases. From 12 downwards, you're going to see the town hall is so far outside. And you can see we're only getting 2-star. None of our town hall 9s here are getting 3-star tier. Again, another one. And just getting attacked from their number 6, who's a town hall 10, attacking our number 13. And another one. See, all of our bases here have got centralized clan castle, but town halls to the side. And that's what helps us do a lot. That's what helps us win those wars. They can't 3-star our town hall 9s. They're struggling so much. And we're 3-starring their town hall 9s with quite ease, except me. And, but yeah, so again, do not max out your base. I advise you guys to go to 0.5. So if you're a town hall 8, go to town hall 9, 8.5. Do not build expos and max those troops for town hall 9. You're going to be absolutely solid, and any clan would want to have you, honestly. Same for town hall 10. Don't put another expo or inferno towers. Just get that. Get to all those town hall 10 troops maxed, and be accepted to any clan if you've got max troops and not a max defense at all. Just maybe get all walls 11, you'll be a town hall 9 with 11 walls. That's just beast. But anyways guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Is the guy going to be attacking? No, not yet. Hope you enjoyed it. I know these are quite weak, not weak tips, these tips, but these are solid tips here. These definitely help you win a clan wars. This is in the more advanced end of a clan wars. If you're against, like, if you're in a clan with quite a lot of rush people, then this won't really work here. But in the higher end of a clan wars, like level 7 clans, you're definitely want to be using this base, because you only want to be 2-star. 2-star is not a loss in our clan. That is a great defense in all of our eyes. Level 1-star is even better. But anyways guys, hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed these tips. I hope you guys can take these in if you're a great warring clan and use them. But that's gonna wrap it up for me. And yeah, let's just hope we can get 10 more wins from this without a single loss. And I've got something coming up for our 200th war win just on this, so stay tuned for that in about 2 weeks. But anyways guys, that's gonna wrap it up. Hope you enjoyed it, and bye bye.